Hey chess lovers, welcome back to the Chess Yard. This is Dheere Bagga, and today I'm showing you one of my top games that I have played over the last 6 months. And now this was against a much stronger rated opponent here. I was playing as white and I started off with d4. My opponent responds with knight f6. I'll put my phone on mute. And then bishop comes out onto f4. Opponent plays e6, so I was playing the London system setup. So I start then proceeded with e3. And generally in London, you will see a strong pyramid in the center. So I was going for that. Opponent played c5. I went to knight f3, defending the pawn too. Opponent plays bishop e7. And now finally, the pyramid is completed by placing c3. Opponent plays b6, trying to free and get out the bishop from b7 there. And then I went with knight b to d2, trying to connect both my knights. Opponent goes with bishop b7, and the kingside diagonal. I went with queen e2, just trying to place my queen in a better position. But then bishop comes on a6. That was an interesting idea by the opponent, trying to spoil my castling rights, maybe trying to take away my light square bishop. So I just move my queen away. Opponent does take. I take back with the knight so that my castling rights are not spoiled. Opponent goes for d5 finally, trying to acquire the center completely. I went with knight e5. It's a very controlling square in the London. Always try and acquire knight, the e5 square with your knight. Opponent castles. And here I go with queen to c2. Now, queen c2 is eyeing the h7. And that's the idea behind queen to c2 generally. Opponent places bishop to d6. And here I started with my attack going for h4. The pawn storm is going on. And now knight comes to d7. And I played knight to d2, trying to maneuver my knight back onto f3. Opponent goes for queen to c7. I place my knight to f3 so that both the knights are connected. Now opponent goes with knight to e4. And here I trade off the knights. And then I went with knight to e5 again. Opponent does take with the bishop. I take back. And now in this position, it's move number 17. And both the players are pretty much equal here. Black has slight advantage, that too because of the knight is controlling very nicely here. The center can be open up anytime. Rooks are connected, whereas white hasn't castled yet. Now, before we continue with this further, I request you to subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of the videos that I'm posting up daily without a miss. After this, my opponent plays f6. I had to escape with my bishop, so I went bishop to h2. Opponent gets the rook onto the c-file, making sure that once the pawn trades happen, my queen will be independent. I try to take the knight back by placing f3. Knight goes back, and I take on the pawn on c5. Opponent takes back, and here I take the knight as well, removing all the minor pieces from the game. And then I played h5. Opponent plays e5. I continue pushing the pawn to h6. Opponent here plays g6, which allows me to have an idea that I can checkmate from g7 with my queen there. So I went with queen to a4, trying to maneuver my queen. Here my opponent sees an opportunity to attack the pawn on b2, but that is what makes me go into d7. Opponent tries to kick my queen and take up free pawn. That's a check. And now I defend the pawn. Opponent tries to add a diagonal. I attack the rooks. Opponent has to defend both the rooks, and then I just move my king onto f2. Opponent continues to push, and I double up here on the center file. Now rook goes there onto g8. I try to double up my rooks as well, and then yes, that happens finally. And here I try to exchange the queens because I am ahead in the game, as you see, 4.1. And after rook to b8, I place my rook to d8. Now, one of the rooks will be exchanged for sure. I have a passed pawn here, and I'll be able to grab these pawns too. And here in this position, maybe my opponent didn't even see that rook to f8 saves the game. Maybe the opponent thought that opponent will take here. I'll take back. And then the only legal move here is rook to f8. And then you take and it's mate. Thanks to the h6, as always. So I hope you like the video. Do let me know your feedback. Keep watching and sharing. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already by now, and I shall see you tomorrow with some interesting and instructive content as always. Thanks for your time. Take care. Bye-bye.